Before we get started, we're just gonna start with outwards. We're gonna start with just a little warm-up song. So just copy me so everyone can get locked in and we can not have to repeat instructions twice. So I'm gonna give us one song to get our camera situations all figured out. Copy along because these skills will actually come back. So copy along as much as you can. Thumbs up if we can hear the music. This topic is, it's really going to be us throwing a bunch of ideas at you with a couple little exercises. And then I've made a Google Drive of the full lessons, and I can give that to you guys to work on your own time when we aren't in a crunch to get everything in an hour. So don't be overwhelmed if you feel like we're not drilling things out and we're just giving you ideas. That's kind of the goal today, is to give you ideas, try a couple of things together, and then give you a bigger folder to really flesh those out, because my goal is not to tell you how to think, but give you things to think about. So today we're gonna start by just defining cross-training. Throughout this, Nicholas is gonna paste stuff into the chat if you wanna keep up with that and follow along. So we're just gonna start by defining cross-training. So if you look in the chat, we're gonna paste it in. Basically, cross-training is in sports when you play more than one sport so that you get better at the sport that you are actually pursuing. So if I was a basketball player, I might cross-train track and field so that I get faster. So I'm gonna take that concept and apply it to swing dancing, but more specifically SHAG. So as I'm giving a couple of examples, go ahead and think about some ways. Why would we cross train and how would we cross train? So go ahead and start dropping into the chat some ideas of why cross training would be beneficial. The example I've mostly come up with is, for example, if I wanted to work on turns, I may not have access to a high level instructor locally. I had to learn by watching YouTube videos. There wasn't a high level instructor in my area. So what I did is I looked at ballet turn technique. There's lots of high level ballet instructors all over the world in almost every city. So you can get access to very technical training, high level training by just cross training in a dance that does that skill gap. So example, tap dancing for my foot articulation. There's just all kinds of ways you can have access to really high level instructors with a wealth of knowledge and a lot of research behind them if you cross train for a skill gap. So that's a reason why I cross train. I'm just gonna look in the chat to see. You guys go ahead and drop in your own ideas why you might cross train a different dance to get better at SHAG. Any thoughts?
Sam Sunny says we need the physical conditioning to bounce for hours and hours.
Yeah, I played club basketball when I was younger. I still, for my foot speed, do a lot of the fast twitch drills. And there's a ton on YouTube from basketball coaches and skills coaches. It's a great one. Any other ideas?
Walking meditation, great for body awareness.
Yeah, body awareness can come from all different types of disciplines and pursuits. What else?
Endurance for SHAG and dancing many hours. Yeah, you need that.
Yeah, for sure. So what I'm going to do is we're actually going to cover three very specific ideas of cross training today. And Nicholas is going to go ahead and put that in. But the three we're going to focus in is closing a skill gap of some kind, finding inspiration for stylings within our already established move sets, and finding new moves and combos from other disciplines. So the first thing we're gonna do is do a little exercise around cross training. So what I'd like you to do is think about a gap that you have in your skill that you either wanna fix or that you've been working on and drop it into the chat. And then as a group, we're gonna unmute when we have something to say and we're gonna game plan a way to cross train that, different things that we can do to fix that. So I already mentioned my turns were my problem and I didn't have the access to the dance instructor I need from SHAG or watching YouTube. So when I was at Paris Jazz Roots, I did a ballet routine with one of the instructors there, and that's what gave me the idea to work on turn from ballet. So I'm gonna look in the chat. What kind of skills are you guys struggling with, getting help with, or trying to fix in your dancing right now? It could be like footwork, it could be turns, it could be connecting to your partner, momentum. What kind of things? So I see turns and balance, turns. Any other ideas? Turns. Momentum. Momentum solo, yeah. I actually have a whole bunch of drills for momentum and solo in the Google Drive I'm gonna share with you guys. Musicality, balance and chord strength. Okay, awesome. I feel like keeping up speed with a relaxed style, totally. Actually, I would like to try that. Let's work on that one because that's a really hard thing to solve. So go ahead and unmute yourself if you have an idea of what we can do to cross train so that we can work on relaxation and speed at the same time. So go ahead and unmute yourself and talk if you have something to say because I won't be able to see all the hands. Even if you're not sure if it's right, you can go ahead.
I think maybe trying to dissociate the lower part of the body while keeping relaxed the upper part. I think it could help to endurance more in doing SHAG, for example.
100%. Throw out some ideas, everybody. What are dances that we see every day on YouTube or in the wild or on Instagram that use a lot of body isolation.
Twerk, yeah, locking, popping.
Twerking, yes. Locking, popping, a lot of hip hop, Latin dances, bachata, I think. Yes. So if you're working on relaxation, you don't just have to drill your shag and try to relax. You can cross train in a dance that's focus is relaxing. So like hip hop, like West Coast swing,
Zouk.
Like Zouk. It's all about body isolation. So there's a lot of highly skilled instructors usually available in your area who can teach you these skills, and you can take them, go back to your shag and incorporate them in a way that's specifically shag. So that's my encouragement to you. I felt stuck for a long time and I felt powerless to improve because I was narrowing my mind too much to look for only shag dancers who could help me. As soon as I expanded my mind to start looking for other highly skilled instructors in my area who could fix my problem, that I could then translate that into shag, that I was getting better faster and faster and faster, and I felt challenged again and I didn't feel bored or frustrated, and it was a really big moment for me. And a lot of those teachers are teaching on Zoom right now. The tap dance class I'm taking is on Zoom. The ballet skills I'm taking right now is on Zoom. They're from all over the world, the best of the best teaching these techniques. And I'm feeling challenged and excited and learning things new all the time instead of stuck and bored and without a partner and quarantined some of the time. So that would be my encouragement to you, because I think we're all feeling a little stuck in quarantine and powerless to improve, but we just have to get a little more creative with cross training. Awesome. So that's part one. Part two is going to be stealing some styling. So this is a little bit more hands-on. We're going to do a drill for turns because I got inspired for watching Latin dances. When I watch Latin dances or West Coast swing, they do some crazy turns. They do like 1,000 turns on one foot. And I was like, this is amazing. Why are shag turns so boring? They look cool and clean, boom, but there's no styling. Why doesn't anybody play with cool turn stylings? We have thousands of turns every time that we look at a contest or we social dance. Why do we never do anything with them? So today we're gonna look a little bit at turn stylings. And I encourage you to go out into the wild and watch all different kinds of partner dances, especially fast ones, and look at how are they styling their turns and where can I use that? So today we're gonna do a tuck turn drill. I'm gonna give you a specific example and then you can go on from there. So time to actually move our bodies. A way you can style tuck turns, this is for follows, you can do this solo or partner. Leads, when I lead, I do these in barrel turns, and I do these in he goes, she goes. So you should also practice your turns because the number of leads that can do great turns are like this small. So if you can do amazing turns, you will totally stand out on the social floor and you will look so cool with just this one thing. So we're gonna take some ideas that I got from Latin stylings on turns, and we're gonna put those into shag. So the way that I style turns, I break it very simply. I style 5/6 of the run. So all that you have to do to make a turn styling is do a regular basic to establish your look. So let's say I go lilty, run, slow, quick, slow, quick, quick would be my turn. To style it, all that I have to do is make the quick of my turn totally different style of quick push by either making it higher or back or the opposite in some way of my turn. So if I'm going slow, quick, quick would be my normal turn. I would go slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick. It looks like I've done a fancy styling, but I've literally just contrasted my quick. If you look at that partner, so we'll do some basic one. And then whenever he turns, and so you can make it look super fancy without actually trying very hard. So there's one idea. The other is to completely change the move on 5/6. So today I'm going to go an out in. So with these turns, we'll go slow, out in. So go ahead and try that together. 5/6/7/8, slow, out, in. Two more times. 5/6/7/8, slow, out, in. 5/6/7/8, slow, out, in. So for the turn, you do the same thing. It would look like this. Slow, out, in. Slow, quick. Try that on your own. 5 seconds. I'll do it again if you want to copy me. I'll do it 4 or 5 times in a row, but you can also just stop and figure it out for yourself if that's easier for you to learn. So it'll look like this. Slug, slug, out, in, slug. Out in, out in, out in, out in. Awesome. So we'll show it partnered so you can see that. So just some ideas for playing with 5-6. Just change your run or just substitute something for 5-6. The other just random thought I'll throw out there is you can steal 1 and 2.
Sam says she can't get all the way around.
Okay, so a cheat for getting all the way around would be slug, slug. I'm gonna use this to jump sideways, jump around. So my first quick is already completely sideways to make it easier to get around. So it would be slug, slug, open. I'm already sideways, close. And I'm just jumping, close, boom, boom, boom. So you can do wall turns as a drill for that. Yeah, nice, Martina. Yes, okay. Yeah, that looks super cool. Now, what we're gonna do is just a quick idea of throwing in a 4-count styling. As a follow or a lead, you can actually steal 1 and 2 from the next basic without disrupting your partner. So I'm gonna use a swoop to demonstrate this. So with the swoop, it would look like 1, 2, 3, 4, and then I'm gonna swoop 6, 7, 8. Still on my right foot for follows, left foot for leads. So let's try that together very slowly. So we'll go step, gather, step, gather, jump, rotate, rotate, rotate. This is super hard to do slow, so you kind of just have to go for it. So I'll show you a little faster, and it will go like this. 7, 8, slow, slow, jump, 2, 3, 4. Now, in real life, it's not gonna be 4 counts, it's gonna be these counts. It'll be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that 4-count sweep will be the end of 5-6 and the beginning of 1-2. So let's do that a few times together or on your own, whichever's easier for you, but I'll just count a bunch of them in a row and I'll go slow and then a little faster. So this will look like 6, 7, 8, slow. 12, 6, and 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12,
seven, eight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 12.
I'll do it with a partner now so you can see why I make that four count take the first half of the basic.
So Nicholas is gonna give me a turn. And you can either watch her come up or go along. And I'll go slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick.
So I'm gonna say his basic footwork, but you'll see that my footwork is different so you can see where they line up and where they don't. I'll do it with my back to you so it's easier to see.
5, 6, 7, 8, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick.
You'll notice I can do that without disrupting my partner. And I'll do it once really fast so you can see why I would do that in a fast song.
5, 6, 7.
So in a fast song, stealing 1, 2 of the next count allows you to make something big and dramatic if it's in the music without messing up your partner. So that's just three levels to play with. When we move on to the partnered activity, if you're home and soloed, I'll have that Dropbox folder in the chat. You can continue to work through those lessons if you'd rather just keep going solo. I just know, like, for me, it's really hard when I take a partnered class as a solo human.
Just a small note from a leader's perspective on this.
Yes.
Followers, this is awesome. Just keep in mind your stylings to a point, if they start to really mess up the connection between us, maybe keep it in the practice session before you roll it out.
Yeah, if you can't do it alone, maybe like wait to roll it out so that you don't surprise someone or kill someone.
Yeah.
And that's kind of why I wanted to give this, because I know for me, I was stuck only practicing alternative basics when I was solo practicing. And then I realized when I go back to partner dancing, I'm gonna know all these cool basics, but that's it. So I wanted to try and start drilling something solo that would allow me to connect to partner dancing and level up the second that I saw a partner. So I got inspired by Latin dancing. I encourage you to watch other partner dances and see what they do that's super cool with styling and see where you can incorporate that. In the drive, you'll see I have examples of arms, of height, of speeding up and slowing down, because I can use my partner connection to do that. And there's solo drills for how to do that if you don't have a partner at home. And so just using other dances and seeing, is it arms? Is it their turns? Like, what makes it so cool? And where can I use that in moves that I already know in SHAG, like hand to hand or college kicks? There's so many cool stylings that people just never even explore. So I encourage you to do that so that next time we're out social dancing, I'm seeing all these cool stylings. I'm like, oh man, I'm gonna steal that. Awesome. So we're gonna do just one demo of a he goes, she goes, and a barrel turn, and then we're moving on.
And theoretically, if I had prepped for class a little better, I would be able to do the styling with her as well, but I didn't, so I'm not going to.
And just something to note when I'm leading, as my follow does a cool styling, if I see it, I'll lead another turn and like try and hop on board with that. Because like the open close, you can do while you're running and she's open closing. And if he does a double turn, I should still be mobile enough to go.
Can you do a double turn?
Yeah.
So if I do this four count styling, I need to be balanced enough to do it on a double count trip as well. So if you're gonna steal 1-2, you have to be balanced enough to keep going if he keeps leading it.
Show it one more time.
So I'll show it one more time. So just some stuff to play with and think about. Cool. So he goes, she goes. You can either keep practicing on your own or watch this other context, and then we'll move on to the partnered stuff. So over here, slow, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick, slow, slow, quick, quick. So, you know, that's an opportunity for the lead to style if they choose to, or for me just to style if I choose to, because I'm basically just chilling here. So I can do something crazy without disrupting him, as long as I can leave my hand still. The other place is a barrel turn. So go forth, be your best Latin self, and channel all of the cool turn things and come up with some of your own that are you and only you. Cool. So at this point, can you drop the Google share?
Yeah.
And then I'm gonna see the comment. Murder mystery. Nice. Or drop a dance. That's hilarious. Okay. Kudos to Murder on the Dance Floor. Who was it? Oh, Patricio. Classic Patricio. All right, so everybody, play with that on your own time. And we're gonna move on to a partnered activity for how to convert combos and moves into SHAG. If you're solo, you can follow along if you prefer that, or you can use the Dropbox, the Google Drive content that I'm putting in the link right now. Nicholas is putting in the link right now, that will continue to explore this. So you can follow those activities to try like the arm stuff, or try putting your own two count moves in, or playing with height. So you can keep following those activities, or you can follow along with the partner. That's totally up to you. While he's doing that, I do want to try. Oh, you got it?
I think so.
Can I get a thumbs up that everyone can see the drive folder if you're solo? Okay. If you're having a problem with it, put it in the chat. Okay, so the two categories we've covered so far, cross-training to close a skill gap or to get access to good instruction if you don't have it locally. Two, stealing stylings that you can put into shag moves you already know, like a tuck turn or cross kicks or hand-to-hand or sliding doors. Sliding doors is like the best place ever to style without messing up your partner, because you can literally do anything cool as long as you catch for the kick on the other side. Like, I do all sorts of weird stuff. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. I'm still trying to figure out how to do a cartwheel and catch on the other side, because that's like my ultimate goal in life. Maybe happen, maybe you won't. All right, so moving on, we're gonna do the partner stuff now. Follow along or keep going with the solo content in the drive. So when we were trying to figure out how to steal a move, we actually decided to go with salsa because
there was salsa music playing next door.
And Nicholas has some expertise. So we're gonna do the combo just to demo it, then we'll break it down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, with just a forward and back basic, very similar feel to Charleston. So it would go right foot forward, forward. Follows. One, two, three, five, six, seven. So partner up or solo, let's try that. As a follow, I'm going to be on this side of the screen if you want to orient yourself the same with your solo. Back and together. Front and together. Your follows and leads.
Switch leaders to underhand. Break away. Get close. And here you're prepping for the Texas Tom.
So. All right, so from the beginning to there. Back, five, six, seven, away, together. Five, six.
Yeah.
Okay.
A note on the Texas Tommy portion. Leaders, you really wanna, when you take that, one, two, three, you step off the slot, your right foot is gonna be on the slot, but you're gonna step off of it the next turn. And you want to be very close to your partner so that you can easily just put this hand behind the back here. If you start to feel like you're about, you know, any distance away, you start to have to lean, and that gets into headbutting territory. So generally, you want to avoid that.
Hope I'm not in a bad mood.
Yeah. So we have one, two, three, five, six, seven. And leaders, you're going to prep to turn underneath this arm on one, two,
turn styling.
One, two, three. You're prepping again this turn on three, so you're taking it out so that your partner knows that you're going to go underneath this face. Five, six, seven, switch hands. Okay.
All right, so let's get all the way to the Texas Tommy together. We'll face this way so you can see what's happening with my arm. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, away, together, five, six, seven. Let's do that together. Three or four times. Let's do this one more time. Six, seven, eight, back and together, front and together, away, together, Texas Tom. We're facing each other right now, and I can look through the little hoop of his eye. We'll go side to side two times, and then we'll watch and give feedback. Six, seven, eight, away, or back, forward, away, together, Texas Tom. I'm balanced on my left foot, if you need to check. He's balanced on his right foot.
Yes.
Last time, and then we'll give feedback. Six, seven, eight. Back and together, forward and together. Away, together, Texas Tom. I'll say the footwork with walks and holds. Walk, walk,
walk, walk, pull. Walk, walk, pull. Walk, walk, pull. So if we would stop and high five. So do you mind demoing that while I watch?
No, not at all.
All right, so Nicholas is going to count it along with you guys, and I'm just going to kind of look. If you have a specific question, throw it in the chat.
What count do you want? You want walk, walk, hold?
Yeah, walk, walk, hold. 5, 6, 7, 8, walk.
Walk, walk, hold. Walk, walk, hold. Walk, walk, hold. Walk, walk, hold.
Yeah. Everyone who did it that time looked really, really good. Awesome, so we're gonna keep going. So we'll start from the beginning, freeze on the hold, then we'll keep going together. So it'll look back, together. Forward, together. Away, together. Walk, walk, pull. Now he's gonna continue to go through and I'm just gonna walk, walk, pull exactly where I am. So I'm balanced on my left, right, left, right. Now here, as he goes under his arm, he's sticking his left arm out.
Right arm.
Oh, his right arm, not this one. It's really, really straight, which is important because I have a lot of connection here. As he pulls forward, I feel that pressure.
Okay.
Boom, boom, boom. Which is what brings me through and creates that turn. So we're gonna go from the beginning, he freezes on the Texas Tommy. So it'll go 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7. So we're here in the underarm turn. Then he's gonna step, step, step. He's got his stop sign out to the side. I'm connected with it. And then step, step, step. Again, I'm balanced on that left. He's balanced on the right. So let's go from the beginning to there. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step, step, step. Step, step, step. Step, step, together. Texas tongue. Step, step, step. Turn, turn, step. Step, step, step. And we're back together. We'll do it one more time, then we'll watch if you have any questions. Confusing, lots of videos to pay attention. Yes. Definitely have the breakdown for all of these things in the videos to make it easier to practice. All right. So from there to there. Back and together, forward and together, away, connect, step, 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 turn, turn, step, 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 together. We're back in closed. Can you count it off?
Yeah.
Let me watch and see what's going on.
5, 6, 7, walk, walk, hold, walk, walk, hold, break, tummy, walk, walk, hold, walk, walk, hold, walk, walk, hold. Way.
All right, we're going to do it two more times and then we'll demonstrate it again.
5, 6, 7, walk, walk, hold, walk, walk, hold, way to the tummy, turn, turn underneath, walk, walk, hold, turn, 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 walk away together.
Yeah. Miguel, and I can't see the other name. Is it Nira? Naria? Miguel and Naria? Yeah, that's it. That's it. Very good. I'm going to watch one more time. Here we go.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Walk, walk, hold. Away.
Walk, walk, hold.
Yeah. Away. Texas, together. Texas Tommy.
Walk, walk. Away. Turn, turn. Walk away together.
Yeah, Martina. Yeah, look at that. Okay, and they're looping it too.
Awesome. So what we're going to do is just count it off one more time with instructions and then keep going. So again, it's back and together, back and together, away, together, Texas Tommy, step in place, turn, 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 away, into closed, finish the circle. So that last little bit is away and to close, finish the circle.
Leaders, to make this tight, I'm going walk and stepping on the outside of my partner, and then hooking behind my right foot and marching in place before ending up facing the slot that I originally had.
Good. So we'll do it with you two times, then I'll watch two times. Awesome. And specific questions, throw them in the chat. We're happy to sit and break it down. So here is going to be coming in today. Together, away.
away, together, touch, says tummy, stand in place, turn, walk, and together, finish the turn. So now we're basically it's side by side. We'll do that last time, then I'll watch. Away, together, Texas tummy, turn, cheek, under arm, away, together, boom, side by side. Awesome. Nicholas is going to do it two times alone, and I'm going to watch. Wave at me frantically or put it in the chat if you want me to look at you specifically.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, rock away, 1, 2, 6, tummy. 5, 6, 7, under the arm, 1, 2, 3, turn, 5, 6, 7, rock away, come together, hook and turn. Oh, we're not doing it.
Yeah, last time.
5, 6, 7, 8, walk together, bump. 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7.
Okay, cool. There's one spot that I'm seeing is messing a couple people up, so I'm going to go over it, but it's almost there. So once we do the ones together where it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, away, here, Texas Tommy, then what happens is he goes on his arm, step, I don't move, and then I go back to where I was, step, turn. So let's go from Texas Tommy really quick. So it's gonna go
1, 2, 3.
Yeah, wait, what are we doing? Left.
I guess I'm on the left. You're on your right.
Yeah, okay. So I'm balanced on my right, ready to step on my left. 6, 7, 8, flex.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Then he's gonna go under his arm. 1, 2, 3. Then I'm gonna switch sides. 5, 6, 7.
I'm not sure if this is exactly what the leaders were messing with, Julie, but
it's the hand to the side.
It's the hand to the side. Okay, so one of the things to help generate that hand to the side. Leaders is if you step off the slot, and there are a number of stylings and ways that salsa teachers will show this. I'm just going to show one of them. So we've got our Texas Tommy. 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, get off the slot. 1, 2, 3, get off the slot.
When he goes under his arm, he's moving out of my way.
So it's not so much that I'm extending my arm, it's that I'm extending my body to create that space for my partner to go. It's like a left side pass, like, you know, when you do like a sort of a thing, but I'm doing it with my back turns, sort of a thing.
So last time, then we'll go through the whole combo. So back and forth, front and away, together, turn, here. He gets out of my way, turn, away, together, finish the circle. And then from there, all that we do is a side pass. So walk. Walk.
Otherwise known as a crossbody.
The end. So we're gonna do it a few times together, and then it won't matter if you have it right or wrong for the part of the exercise that's important. So try to get it right as much as possible, but if it's not working for you, don't stress. We're just gonna take one piece of this, okay? So do your best, but don't stress if it's not working 100%.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Walk. Away, together. Texas time. Stay in place. Turn. Away together. Finish the circle. Rock. 3 more times. How many did I say? That's half my time.
I don't know.
Alright, 3 more times for real.
5, 6, 7, 8.
Rock together. Rock together. Away together. Turn. He goes. I go. Away. Together, turn, together. Walk together, side, pass.
2 more?
You can either watch us or do it yourself, whatever's gonna help you get better. Watch the chat. Yes, Julia, it's exactly like the down basic. Except in Latin, they like make it cool with their hips, but I can do that, I look really stupid. All right. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. Walk down, turn, down, away, together, turn, sideways, walk down, pass, down. All right.
5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Prep the turn. 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I like your hip hop at the end there, Joe. That's nice.
Very Westy.
Yeah, great.
Okay. So now I'm going to watch everyone do the combo one time if you want to count them off. Sure.
5, 6, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, rock away, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, under the arm, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, circle it up and cross body leap, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Yes. I said one more time, but there's one person I want to watch really, really quick.
5, 6,
last time.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Texas, how many? 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, turn. Arm, rock away in circle. 5, 6, 7, 8. Cross body. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Sweet. All right. So here's the challenge. You're going to have about 5 minutes where we're going to turn you loose. And if you have specific questions, you can unmute yourself and ask them now, and we will totally answer them if you have specific questions. But for the rest of you, what I would like you to do is, if you're solo, I want you to take a turn styling, and I want you to either do one of the ones that I gave you or create one of your own. So either on 5, 6, do some different kind of run or some different move substitution. So I want you to come up with a styling or arms or something. Think of a dance that you've seen, or it could even be stealing from Charleston or Lindy Hop, doesn't, or Balboa. Like, it doesn't have to be completely not a swing dance. So take one thing you can think of from another dance and put it into a turn styling if you're solo right now. If you're partnered, you can either do that together, or you can take this combo and make it shag. So we have two examples already filmed and in the drive, but I want you to think, what would I need to change to make this look like shag? What shape and what footwork? So I'll give you guys 5 minutes to play with that and figure it out, either alone or with your partner. And for right now, Nicholas and I are both available for chats in the question or unmuting yourself. Any specific part anyone wants broken down?
And the ones who did a partner are going to do it. You said that?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm listening, I promise.
And especially if you have your video not turned on, I want you to unhide yourself in a minute to show us what you came up with. We're going to have like 2 or 3 people just show us, time allowing, what it was. Zip Lang, I'm not sure if I'm saying your name right, but I love that you're using the bar. That's such a cool thing. I love your setup with the mirror and the bar. You can come up with so much cool stuff with your styling drills.
Yeah, right now I've got a lot of dances in my head from samba and cha-cha.
Yeah.
It's actually, I'm getting overloaded right now.
No problem. I found the same thing when I started to cross train. What I recommend, well, what worked for me, you could totally do whatever you want, but what I ended up doing was making like lists in a Google Drive of like ideas that I had for my feet or ideas that I had for my arms. And sometimes it was too much to think about it right then. But then when I was practicing later, I would go back and look and like, oh, that was a cool thing with the arm. I want to play with that today.
Yeah, because right now there are two things my mind's completely fixated on, but I end up on the wrong foot. That's the only thing I have right now.
Oh, okay. And are you trying to do it 5, 6?
It's basically one of them is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, and then getting back into this foot. I mean, it's like 3, 4, 5, 6. It's that last part which is getting me.
So two ideas. One, you can switch into single shag, which will solve your problems. The one thing I noticed when I started playing with footwork and ending up on the wrong foot is, either if I'm the lead, I have a lot of options. I can say, hey, we're going to be in single shag right now, so that any styling I do, it doesn't matter what foot I end up on, because I can immediately get back on the other foot.
Okay. So switch roles.
So sometimes it's just a matter of setting up the styling that you want with a basic that allows it. So like if Nicholas is doing single shags, he can do a lot of cool things and styling, but he can't do a double. One, two, run, run, one, two, run, run, one, two, run. So even if we're coming out of turns and we're on the wrong foot, we're immediately back. Or sometimes putting four run runs in the basic so that it's already the pattern in the follow's head. Then when you do a four count thing, you'll still end up on the right foot. Something to think, like he establishes that this is our rhythm. Slow, slow, quick, 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 quick. Slow, slow, quick, 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 slow. So if he's leading a bunch of moves with this, slow, slow, quick, 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 slow, and I know that that's the rhythm, then he can do some crazy styling in there. It's not gonna mess me up because he's already told me we're gonna do two slows and four fasts. So either you can fix it so it's six, or you can just be like, I'm changing the rules, baby.
Yeah, I like the setting the rhythm in the beginning. That's actually really helpful.
Yeah, because if the lead is telling me this is our framework, then I'm gonna do all of my moves in that framework, and then it opens the door for other stuff.
Okay, cool, thanks.
Any other question before we come back and convene? Ooh, Sam Bunny, I love your arms. I don't think that's your real name, but that's what I'm going with today. Oh, and speaking of, I totally forgot to hide this somewhere. So you get like a free pass if you need to screenshot it. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I should probably like put it in here. Be free, buddy. Okay. So come back to the screen. Unmute yourselves and just talk right now. We have about 5 minutes to kind of go through either the combo, a way you made it into SHAG, or a styling that you're working on your own. It could be successful or a problem. Either one is valuable because most of the time when I have a problem trying to make something work, it opens totally new doors for another way of thinking that ends up being really valuable even if that one move didn't work. Annie, I liked what you guys were doing if you want to show us. No, but it was cool.
Nicholas and Mina too, I wanted to see what they did.
Oh, Nicholas. Do you want to show us what you did?
Naria and Miguel as well.
Oh yeah, Naria and Miguel. Do you want to unmute and show us what you did? It could be a piece of it, all of it, or even just your thought process.
I don't know if we have any idea, but we just put it together. We can show it.
Yeah, we'd love it. You want us to show? Oh, yeah. And you shaved some counts off of some of the places, which is super cool because it makes it look more SHAG. So yeah, that was awesome. It totally looks like a SHAG. You changed the shape, you changed the footwork, and in some places you shaved counts so that the movement had the right snap to look like SHAG. Awesome. Yeah, a lot of the times when I get new combos, they're not SHAG combos at all. I just steal them from somewhere else because I'm like, well, everyone's already doing the SHAG combos, so why would I do those? All right, Miguel, Nira, Nerea. I cannot see your name. I feel so bad. I'm sorry. Would you guys like to
Nerea. It's Nerea, but it's tricky in English. Nerea, yeah.
Okay.
We are going to show it like SHAG.
Okay. Let's go.
Okay. Ah.
Ooh, nice.
I'm jealous that I didn't think of this. Yeah, I love that camel hop. Totally changes the look and feel. It makes it super cool. I really like it. Anyone else want to show the combo? We only have one other idea, you guys. Yeah, that's perfect. The only other idea we would suggest is at some point when you're adapting these combos, consider doing single or triple shag, because that totally changes the vibe and totally makes it look really interesting, even if it's not really hard. So we also did this combo in single shag. It also gives me really different momentum. It's so much snappier. It opens totally different ideas for styling and totally different rhythms, especially if the song is super like 4-count phrase, like 4-8 phrases where they hit really hard. Sometimes dancing feels odd in 6-count shag. So having a couple combos that hit hard on every count can be really valuable. So again, that pass by all sorts of styling opportunities that shaggers just don't utilize for whatever reason. Steal all of your Lindy Hop pass by stylings and make them shag people. It would take you 5 minutes. 5 minutes. All right.
Billy, what's triple count?
What?
What do you mean by what? I've never heard of the triple timing that you were talking about. I've heard of triple.
Mm-hmm.
What's the triple? I've never.
Three slows.
Okay.
So slow, quick. I personally, if I'm choreographing, I use tons of 4-quick basics, because if I'm doing aerials, I need to hit musically. And so to set up aerials, I use a ton of 4-count basics in tandem and especially in side by side. So like slow, run, 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 slow, run. So you don't have to get stuck just with the traditional 1, 2, 3 slows. You can totally play with the quicks. And there's so many more cool stylings you can do with basics with lots of quicks, because you have enough time to make it show. Like ankle breakers. Slow, quick. Sometimes if you just do an ankle breaker with one quick, it just disappears and no one ever realizes how cool it was. Like I put all that work in and no one ever saw it. It was just gone. So if I feel like I've worked really hard on something and I definitely want to make sure that people see it, sometimes I'll just do a 4-quick basic so I can like do it again. Like, did you see it? Did you see it? Did you see this thing?
Yeah, we do that in tango, where it's like the first time is to make people go, what happened? The second time is to be like, oh, I think something cool is going on. And the third time is so they can actually see it.
Yeah. Any of the solo people want to throw out ideas? I saw some cool arms from Sam. We kind of already talked about what you were working on, Ziv.
Yeah.
What's your cool idea?
Threading the needle, we do this a lot in ballroom lessons.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, so playing with arms, do a lot of videoing of yourself when you're playing with arms, because finding ways to use those lines without making them look too proper is super important in shag. So like you can use those gorgeous arms, but instead of making it so pretty and perfect, find ways to like break it or to make it a little more jagged or to make your hands follow through as a unit, as opposed to like really rolling through. So those are some things to definitely consider, and definitely video yourself to see like, does this look weird compared to all the other things I'm doing around it? Or does it look like it should be there? And if it looks weird, don't scrap it. Just say, how do I need to change it so it doesn't look weird? How do I need to change it so it belongs? Do I just need to make it rougher? Do I just need to make it less precise? Do I just need to make it floppier? Like, or not go as high or as far? If it doesn't look good, don't just kick it out right away. Play with it, video it, see what you can do to change it to make it look like it belongs, and that it's not just like, one of these things is not like the other. Awesome, any other solo people want to chime in? Well, anyone can chime in, but we haven't heard from a lot of solo people. Awesome, so we're basically out of time. So what I'd like is for people to unmute themselves, and just our last thing is share one new idea you have in your head. It could be something we said or something not, but like inspired by what we talked about today, or one cross-training idea you have that you actually would do. Yeah, you can put it in the chat or unmute, either way. Arms inspired by African traditional dance. Cool. There's definitely a lot to work with there and a lot of YouTube content. A lot of YouTube content. A lot of other dances have like studio systems. So there's a lot of money and research and technique and professionals in those areas. So there's a lot of content you can find even just online that's super helpful, super usable. So I know we all look for our YouTube videos for swing, but start looking for instructional videos on turns or for fast drills, or like look outside, look in sports if you're looking for conditioning, because a lot of the stuff we do as Lindy Hoppers isn't actually good for our bodies. We're actually injuring ourselves or getting worse.
Yeah, like if you do 43 lifts in a row, just doing like, you know, what basic stuff in Lindy Hop, then you're probably gonna throw out one of those muscles on your right side.
You don't do like a personal trainer with proper technique.
Yeah, or if you find a really good powerlifting gym, that has been awesome for me for explosive energy, because I was super weak. And Julie's like, no, you suck, like be better. So, you know.
I didn't say it, well, I kind of didn't say it that way.
Like, well, it's her life.
To get strong. Yeah. I am not going upside down until you can lift me.
Yeah.
Awesome, so we have 1 minute now, just throw it out there. Let's hear what you have to say.
I've been trying to put in some of the SHAG lines and styling in my jive, because the pyramids and all of these really exaggerated lines, like I want to put that in promenade position because it looks kind of weird, but cool.
I have no experience in jive, so I can't tell you if that's good or not, but I say go for it and see what happens. Film yourself, see if you like it or not. But I think there's so many cool things. I watched Jive and I agree. There's a lot of crossover in like the music that it's danced to. So there's gotta be a lot of movements you can steal because it's inspired by the same music. Any other thoughts? Okay, awesome. So what's gonna happen? Ooh, Cuban salsa dancer, borrowing shapes and styling. I like the idea of triple single. Yeah. Interested to try all the single or triple? Yeah. That was a game changer for me. I was like, there's so many things that didn't work just because I didn't think to try a different basic. What is my life? So we'll put the Dropbox or Google Drive back here at the end of the chat. We'll also put it on Facebook. It's got everything that we went, but slower and in more detail, because I know we just kind of tore through it just because the point was to discuss the topic and give you a couple of strategies to go from there. I know you had a long day of dancing, plus this is all stuff I wish I had thought about earlier or heard from people earlier, because it would have solved a lot of my frustrations as someone who's often without a partner and someone who's trying to train at a high level. It was like a mentality shift for me that allowed me to not be frustrated, especially through the pandemic. I've been able to find great Zoom classes. I wasn't feeling challenged by a lot of swing Zoom classes just because of how I learn. But then starting as a beginner in another discipline with a highly skilled instructor was huge for me. As like, oh, I'm learning. I'm a beginner again. And these are all skills that will make me a better dancer. So I don't feel like I'm losing out. So through the pandemic, especially if you're solo or stuck, quarantined, check out the Zoom classes for other types of dance. Look at the online instructional videos on YouTube for other kinds of dance or like fitness, because it will only make you feel great about your dancing when you get out of quarantine and back in the wild. You guys are amazing. Because it was so fast, you can friend me on Facebook and message me, or however you want to contact me. Feel free to shoot me practice videos or questions or whatever you need. I love talking about this stuff. And so I am happy for you to send something to me like, how would you fix this? Or for you to say, show me what you would do or challenge me. I will accept challenges too. I like challenges. Awesome. Have a wonderful rest of your day. You guys are awesome. Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.